In this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can improve the conversion rate of your e-commerce website by adding better quality images and also a zoom functionality. Now, here is a quick demo of what we'll be doing. Here is the e-commerce site that I've built in WordPress. On the product page, as you can see, if you select another thumbnail, it pops out in this lightbox feature and you can scroll through. Now this is pretty nice, but there's a better way to do things. If I jump onto this tab here, this is the web page after I've installed a Zoom plugin, which I will be showing you step by step how to do in this tutorial. Now I can actually, when I select a product, a different product image, it actually comes up in the area above. And furthermore, when I hover over that product image, it actually gives me a beautiful zoom so that the users can actually see the finer details of your products. And that's extremely helpful for people purchasing things from your e-commerce website. So I'll be showing you how to implement this onto your e-commerce store. If you haven't already, go and watch my tutorial on how to set up an e-commerce website using WordPress. I'll be showing you step by step how to set up and how to add products and receive payments via your own e-commerce website. So check that out. I'll leave a link in the description below. Okay, let's log into our WordPress dashboard. Now go to plugins, click on the add new button, and we want to add a plugin called YITH Zoom Magnifier. So if you just search for that, you should see this one here. Install now. And activate this plugin. Okay. Now, if I go to my site and view any product, you'll see the difference immediately. So you'll see there was a little loading notification there, and now when I hover over the image, I can see it zoomed in greater detail. Just like that. It's very, very good. It's very clear. Of course, the better your photos, the better the quality, the better the zoom effect will be. It'll be much more clear and much more crisp. So anyway, let's go back in now and you should see a YIT plugins area and let's click on Zoom Magnifier. There are a bunch of settings which I will take you through. First, we want to activate this plugin, enable that. We want to activate it on a mobile device. Now, if you get your mobile phone out, you can see how that works. Yes, we want to force the image size. Now, I strongly recommend you not to disable this, so leave that ticked. Here in the magnifier settings, for image size, this is the size of the images used in the magnified box. So I am going to actually change mine from 600 to 700 by 700, slightly larger than what you're seeing here. The zoom box position, right? You can change that if you want so that the zoom appears on the inside. Now, let me just show you as I go through this what change that makes so it's crystal clear for you. So I've made that change. I'm just refreshing my site. And that's what it looks like when the zoom functionality is within the original image box. So it's completely your choice if you want it to appear on the inside or if you want it to appear on the outside. Now, I've seen a lot of e-commerce stores which have both of these methods, so feel free to choose the one which you think will be best for you. There is no right answer. It completely depends on your personal preference. Then you can select a zoom box position for mobile devices as well. Default inside, or you can disable the zoom completely. Let's leave that as inside. loading label. Now, when I load up a new image, you'll see for a split second there is a notification that says loading. Now, you can change that wording if you like. I'll leave lens opacity and blur as is default. I'll leave blur disabled. Now back into the slider settings. Yes, I want to activate the thumbnail slider. That is this part over here. So you'll remember previously it was slightly different. Previously, when I clicked on one of these images, it would open in a light box. But now when I click on one of these, it actually opens within this window here. And if I had more images, I'd be able to browse through with the left and right arrows. I will leave everything else as default and then save changes when you're ready. Now, I like my zoom on the outside, so I'll keep it as on the right hand side. I'll save my settings and I'll refresh my page. So there you go. If you have any questions, please do ask in the comments below, and please thumbs up this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more awesome stuff on improving your e-commerce store and conversions. Speak to you next time.